Let's start question number second of exercise 7th B. Question is, use multiplication to write two equivalent fractions of these fractions. We have to write equivalent fractions of these fractions by using multiplication. So let's start. A part is 2 upon 5. How we will find the equivalent fraction? I'll multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. So here I am taking 2. And if I multiply the numerator and denominator by 2, it will... And next I am going to multiply this fraction by 3. Multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. So it will become 6 upon 15. So two equivalent fractions of 2 by 5 are 4 by 10 and 6 upon 15. Fine? This is your answer. B part is 3 upon 8. Okay, in the first step, I am going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. It will be 3 2's are 6 and 8 2's are 16. And next, I am going to multiply it by 3. Fine, 3 3's are 9 and 8 3's are 24. So, the equivalent fractions of 3 by 8 are 6 by 16 and 9 by 24. You can multiply the numerator and denominator by any number, but one thing you have to keep in mind is that the numerator and denominator should be same. Okay, the number you are taking for multiplying in the numerator should be same as the denominator. You cannot multiply, like if I am having 3 by 8, multiplying numerator by 2 and denominator by 3. No, this is totally wrong. Okay, in equivalent fractions, we multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. C part is 10 upon 11. So I am taking 2 firstly. I am multiplying the numerator and denominator by 2. 10 2's are 20 and 11 2's are 22. This is your first equivalent fraction of 10 by 11. And secondly, I am going to multiply it by 3. It will be 30 upon 33. So, two equivalent fractions of 10 upon 11 are 20 upon 22 and 30 upon 33. Okay, these are two equivalent fractions of 10 upon 11. Next is 12 upon 30. 12 upon 13. Firstly, I am going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. 12 2's are 24 and 13 2's are 26. And next, 3. Okay, 12 3's are 36 and 13 3's are 39. Fine. You can take 4 also. Okay. But here we have to find only 2 equivalent fractions. That's why I am taking first 2 numbers. You can take 4, you can take 5, any numbers you can take. Okay. So this is question number 2nd of exercise 7th B.